breaking, major NFL star just found dead overnight and the reason why is absolutely horrific. This football season will forever go on record as being the most difficult one in the history of the league. Although problems began when Colin Kaepernick decided to take a knee and start a disgusting trend that has since destroyed the industry, they are getting worse by ending up with deaths and incarceration. It will be difficult to come back from this demise, especially after news just broke today of one NFL star who was just found dead overnight, brought about by horrific circumstances. Football fans are not just mourning the loss of their favorite sport, they are now waking to tragic news of the passing of one of the league's finest who had a prominent role representing the sport for what it really was before anti-American athletes hijacked it. This shocking news of a talented and noble player gone far too soon comes within days of reports of another prominent football star who will spend the rest of his life behind bars, and another current player who has also been accused of a depraved crime. Pro Football Talk reports. According to multiple reports, longtime NFL wide receiver Terry Glenn died Monday morning at the age of 43 due to injuries suffered in a car accident. Glenn grew up in Columbus, Ohio and stayed in town to start at Ohio State before being drafted 7th overall in the 1996 draft. He got off to a rocky start with then-coach Bill Parcells because Parcells referred to Glenn as she, but he caught 90 passes for 1,132 yards and 6 touchdowns as a rookie to help the Patriots advance to the Super Bowl for the second time in franchise history. Glenn would have 2 more strong seasons with the Patriots and caught Tom Brady's first NFL touchdown pass in 2001, but saw his time in New England end as a healthy scratch after disputes with Bill Belichick. He spent 1 year with the Packers and then reunited with Parcells in Dallas. The Cowboys' years featured 2 more 1,000-yard seasons for Glenn in 2005 and 2006, but a knee injury limited him to 1 game in 2007. That was the final game of Glenn's career and he retired with 593 passes, 8,823 yards and 44 touchdowns. Our condolences to Glenn's family and friends on their loss. 0. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. This football season will forever go on record as being the most difficult one in the history of the league. Although problems began when Colin Kaepernick decided to take a knee and start a disgusting trend that has since destroyed the industry, they are getting worse by ending up with deaths and incarceration. It will be difficult to come back from this demise, especially after news just broke today of one NFL star who was just found dead overnight, brought about by horrific circumstances. Football fans are not just mourning the loss of their favorite sport. They are now waking to tragic news of the passing of one of the league's finest who had a prominent role representing the sport for what it really was before anti-American athletes hijacked it. This shocking news of a talented and noble player gone far too soon comes within days of reports of another prominent football star who will spend the rest of his life behind bars, and another current player who has also been accused of a depraved crime. Pro Football Talk reports. According to multiple reports, longtime NFL wide receiver Terry Glenn died Monday morning at the age of 43 due to injuries suffered in a car accident. Glenn grew up in Columbus, Ohio and stayed in town to start at Ohio State before being drafted 7th overall in the 1996 draft. He got off to a rocky start with then-coach Bill Parcells because Parcells referred to Glenn as she, but he caught 90 passes for 1,132 yards and 6 touchdowns as a rookie to help the Patriots advance to the Super Bowl for the second time in franchise history. Glenn would have 2 more strong seasons with the Patriots and caught Tom Brady's first NFL touchdown pass in 2001, but saw his time in New England end as a healthy scratch after disputes with Bill Belichick. He spent 1 year with the Packers and then reunited with Parcells in Dallas. The Cowboys' years featured 2 more 1,000-yard seasons for Glenn in 2005 and 2006, but a knee injury limited him to 1 game in 2007. That was the final game of Glenn's career and he retired with 593 passes, 8,823 yards and 44 touchdowns. Our condolences to Glenn's family and friends on their loss. The last thing the league needs is more bad news, as it seems like it comes in droves, and at least lately, on the daily. Just last week, we reported that a currently playing athlete for the Buccaneers was accused of sexual assault by his Uber driver, who withheld her harrowing account of what she said happened to her for nearly 2 years. This came out after it was discovered that a former Dallas Cowboy was arrested on murder charges for slicing his wife's neck and killing her. Former Dallas Cowboy Anthony D. McClanahan will be spending the rest of his life in prison. All that wealth and status didn't stop him from stabbing his wife to death, trading in his baller lifestyle for a new life behind bars. He will certainly be treated equally there, just like one of the other felons in his cell block, so he should be pretty happy about that. But now he's not the only notorious NFL player with an unfortunate run-in with the law. The problem with these players is that they think they are above the rules and law and can do whatever they want without being caught or punished for it, simply because they achieved fame by being able to play a game better than others. That's far from the truth, and this failure of a season should have proved it, but Buccaneers quarterback Jameis Winston just found that out the hard way when he tested the limits and more than crossed the line, based on what a female Uber driver is accusing him of. The Daily Snark explains the allegations against current Buccaneers quarterback Jameis Winston. According to BuzzFeed News, Jameis Winston has undergone investigation for allegedly sexually assaulting an Uber driver in 2016. The Buccaneers QB reportedly grabbed her by the crotch on March 12 in Scottsdale, Arizona, while in the fast food lane. The team was in town for a Kurt Warner's charity flag football event. The accuser described the incident in an Uber incident report, saying, "While we were stopped, this rider reached over and put his fingers on my crotch, and it was only for a very brief moment. It's tragic that the good players perish and others abuse the opportunities they were given. Our thoughts and condolences are with the Glenn family in this difficult time of coping with their sudden loss. May this horrific tragedy serve as a reminder to not take anything for granted, and that life is truly short, too short to destroy a perfectly good career in football league over pushing a divisive political statement."